The human brain controls the rest of the body by sending signals through the spinal cord, out through nerves that connect to the muscles and other organs of the body, telling them what to do. But there are actually 12 pairs of nerves that bypass the spinal cord altogether, the 12 cranial nerves. So in this video, we're gonna learn all 12 cranial nerves, we'll learn what they do, and we'll learn an acronym to help us remember those 12 cranial nerves for any test or class that you have. We'll use some 3D models from anatomy.app to help us visualize what these nerves look like and what they connect to. And if you're learning all of the nervous system, check out my 2-part study guide that organizes all this information for you and helps you get ready to pass that test or class that you have. So let's jump to the whiteboard and get started. So our diagram for the 12 cranial nerves is actually an inferior view of the brain. So if I take my brain from Anatomy Warehouse here, it's sitting in my head like this. We're actually looking from underneath. And so if I turn this, you can see the view that we're looking at. All of those cranial nerves in yellow, they're sticking off of the diencephalon and the brainstem. Those are the ones that we're learning in this video. Here are the names of the 12 cranial nerves. Now, at first glance, that looks like a lot, but we have an acronym that's gonna help us remember all of those and get them memorized. And that acronym is OOO to touch and feel very good velvet. Now, I don't actually have a piece of velvet here, but I do have this Siebert Science sweatshirt, which is very soft and velvety. Link in the description if you wanna get your own. Sorry to plug that, but I just got this and I'm really excited about it. Now, before we get into all of those nerves, we're gonna take a look at the parts of the brain that we need to know for this video so we can talk about the nerves a little bit better and what they do. First, we have the cerebrum, which includes the lobes of the brain, like the frontal lobe and occipital lobe. We've got the diencephalon, which is the structure that includes the midbrain, the hypothalamus, and the thalamus. I don't have it drawn in a ton of detail here because it's gonna get covered up by a few other things. Next, we have the pituitary gland, which is sticking off the bottom of the diencephalon. We can see that pituitary gland right here in our model. Next, we have the cerebellum, which is gonna be sticking off the posterior and inferior side of the brain right here. Connected to the midbrain of the diencephalon, we've got the pons. So here's the pons right here in our model. And then connected to the bottom of the pons, we have the medulla oblongata, which is gonna form the beginning of the spinal cord as well. If you wanna learn more about those structures of the brain, I've got a couple videos about the brain that I'll link below as well. All right, let's get into the actual cranial nerves and what they do. Our first cranial nerve is gonna be the olfactory nerve, which is gonna be all about smell. I just think of an old factory, an old smelly factory as you're driving down the road. And that olfactory nerve is purely a sensory nerve. It's not gonna send any signals out to tell any part of our nose what to do. It's only gonna be bringing information in. In fact, all of our cranial nerves will be classified as a sensory, a motor, or a mixed nerve, which means it's got some fibers for sensory and some fibers for mixed. So the olfactory nerve is a sensory nerve, and it's gonna carry signals from the olfactory nerve endings, which are hanging down in our nose. They pass through the cribriform plate in our skull. And when chemicals get up into our nose, those sensory nerve endings will detect those, and then they'll send a signal back through our olfactory nerve to a couple different parts of our brain. And so you see there's two stria that split right there. And so there's two different parts of the brain that's gonna send information to the temporal lobe as well as to the brainstem. So the olfactory nerve is a sensory nerve all about smell. All right, let's keep going. OOO to touch and feel very good velvet. So we've actually got three O's we're gonna start with. We've got the olfactory. Up next, we have the optic nerve. The optic nerve is gonna be another sensory nerve, but instead of smell, this one's gonna be about vision. Optic or optical, of course, is referring to the eye. It's sensory only, so it's not gonna move the eye. We're gonna have other nerves, actually three nerves that are gonna be controlling the movements of the eye. The optic nerve is only about sensory information, so it's only sending signals from the eye to the brain. Specifically, that's gonna carry information from the eye's retina and a couple other structures in the eye through the optic nerve back to the occipital lobe in the back of the brain. So the olfactory nerve is sensory information for smelling. Optic nerve is sensory information from our eyes. And the third nerve is gonna be our first motor nerve, and that's gonna be the oculomotor nerve, which is a pretty easy one to remember, I think. Oculo means eye, and motor means motor, or it's gonna be sending signals from the brain out to tell some muscles or other organs what to do. Now, the oculomotor nerve is gonna be controlling most of the eye's movements. It's gonna include things as well like pupil constriction or elevating the eyelid, but there's all these muscles around the eye that the oculomotor nerve is gonna control. Let me grab the eye from my torso model, Tori, here. And you see the eye here. And if I turn it, you'll see all these muscles around the eye. And those muscles are gonna be moving the eye around. The oculomotor nerve controls all but two of those muscles that are moving the eye around. All right, so far we've got three nerves. We've got the olfactory nerve, which is sensory for smell. Optic nerve, which is sensory for vision. We've got the oculomotor nerve, which controls most of our eye movements. There's going to be two other nerves that control eye movements. The first of those is going to be the next one, which is the trochlear nerve. The trochlear nerve is another motor nerve. Specifically, it controls the superior oblique muscle of the eye, which is going to run kind of forward, and then it's going to kind of turn. It's going to go through like a little pulley system here. It's going to turn, and it'll help like rotate the eye. So whenever you're looking downward or kind of looking inward, it's going to help with that movement. So we have O-O-O to touch. That's going to be our next one, is going to be the trigeminal nerve. This is cranial nerve number 5. Also, if you've noticed that each of these nerves start with CN, that stands for cranial nerve, and they're numbered 1 through 12, of course. The trigeminal nerve, I have a special way that I remember that that's cranial nerve number 5. So I think of tri, which means 3, and gemina, or Gemini, refers to the twins in like constellations and stuff. So Gemini is twins, which is 2. So tri plus Gemini, or 2, adds up to 5. So I just remember that's cranial nerve number 5. Kind of weird, but that's how I remember it. The trigeminal nerve is a super important nerve that's going to provide sensory information from the face as well as motor control of chewing. So sensory for kind of the whole face, and then controls our muscles for chewing, muscles of mastication. Now the tri and trigeminal refers to the 3 branches of the trigeminal nerve. Here's the 3 branches. The first one is the ophthalmic branch, and that's gonna be sensory for kind of our forehead and kind of this eye region right in here. Branch number 2 is gonna be the maxillary nerve, which is gonna be sensory for kind of this region above our mouth and includes our upper row of teeth as well. Those are both sensory branches of the nerve. And then finally, we have the mandibular nerve, which is gonna be a mixed branch, meaning it's got sensory and motor information. It's gonna be sensory for kind of this lower jaw and our lower row of teeth, but it's also gonna have motor control of our muscles of mastication, our muscles of chewing, such as our masseter and our temporalis. I've got a whole video on the muscles of mastication. If you need to learn that, check out the link in the description below for that. So the trigeminal nerve, there's 3 branches. It's gonna be sensory for the whole face. And that third branch, the mandibular branch, is gonna be sensory for the jaw here, as well as motor control of the muscles of mastication or chewing. Now, as I go through all this, take some time and pause the video throughout and see if you can remember all of those different nerves that we've talked about. Maybe cover up that part of the screen right there. At the end of the video, I'll have a couple blank diagrams for you to practice this stuff. And I also have A&P study cards. If you were learning a lot of A&P content, I've got stuff that covers kind of the main topics of A&P. So links in the description for those A&P study cards as well. Y'all, I'm sorry, I feel like I keep saying links in the description for all this stuff, but the gist of it is, I've made a lot of resources to help you out. I've also got a free A&P survival guide that teaches you how to learn A&P stuff. So I'm gonna try to stop talking about all these resources I've made, but if you're trying to learn A&P, I've got a lot of stuff that can help you out, and you can find all of that down in the description. All right, let's get back to the video. After the trigeminal nerve, we have nerve number 6, which is the abducens nerve. This is the other nerve that's gonna control eye movements, and specifically, it's a motor nerve, so only controlling movement, and it's gonna control the lateral rectus muscle. That's gonna be a muscle on the side of the eye that's gonna take the eye and turn it outward. So the right lateral rectus will abduct the eye, turn it outward that way, and the left lateral rectus will abduct the left eye and move it out that way. That word abducens is the same root as abduct, which means to kind of move away from the body. O-O-O to touch and feel, so we have to have one that starts with an F, and that's gonna be our facial nerve. The facial nerve is going to be controlling all of the movements of our face. So if you make any silly faces or smile or frown or any of those different things, you're using your facial nerve to control all of those movements. Take a moment, practice using your facial nerve here. That was kind of ridiculous, but if it helps you remember it, then hey, it's worth it. Your facial nerve is a mixed nerve, meaning it has some sensory information, but it's not gonna be sensory for like the different parts of the face. Remember, the trigeminal nerve was the main sensory nerve for the different main parts of the face. So it controls your facial expressions, that's the motor part, and the sensory part is that it's gonna control the anterior 2/3 of the tongue. So sensations from the tip of your tongue and the middle part of your tongue, those are going through the facial nerve. The posterior side of your tongue is gonna be another cranial nerve that we'll talk about in just a minute. So facial nerve is a mixed nerve. It's gonna be for controlling the movements of the face, and it's gonna be sensory for the anterior 2/3 of the tongue. O-O-O to touch and feel vary. So now we're gonna have the vestibulocochlear nerve. The vestibulocochlear nerve is a sensory nerve, and that word vestibulocochlear is a combination of vestibule and cochlear. Vestibule is going to be referring to the main bony structure of your inner ear. It has the semicircular canals, which are going to be detecting balance. And cochlea is referring to the part where it's detecting the sound. So there's actually two branches of the vestibular cochlear nerve, one that's going to go to the semicircular canals of the ear and one that's going to go to the cochlea for sound information. So this is responsible for hearing, that's the cochlear branch, as well as balance, that's the vestibular branch. Quick check-in before we continue. Can you remember which of these are sensory, which are motor, and which are mixed? Olfactory is sensory, optic is sensory, oculomotor is motor, trochlear is motor, trigeminal is mixed, abducens is motor, facial is mixed, and vestibulocochlear is sensory. All right, cranial nerve number 9 is going to be the glossopharyngeal nerve. Glosso, like glossary, it's referring to the tongue. Actually, I don't know what a glossary in a book has to do with the tongue, per se, but glosso means tongue. And pharyngeal, which is the pharynx or the back of the throat. The glossopharyngeal nerve is going to be a mixed nerve. It's going to control some muscles involved in swallowing and saliva production. It's not the main muscle that's moving the tongue, but it's going to control some of the other structures that are involved in that swallowing process. And it's going to be sensory for the posterior third of the tongue, so like the back of the tongue. If you remember, the facial nerve was sensory for the anterior two-thirds of the tongue, and then the glossopharyngeal nerve is sensory for the posterior one-third of the tongue. Up next, we have kind of an amazing nerve. It's cranial nerve number 10. It's called the vagus nerve. And that term vagus is actually Latin for wandering. Same root as like vagabond, a person who wanders. Now, why would we call this the wandering nerve? Well, if you notice, all of the other cranial nerves that we've looked at, they're all controlling things in the face, like your eyes or your nose or your facial expressions. The vagus nerve, however, is actually going to travel from the brain and go down throughout kind of the whole rest of the body. It's going to go down to your digestive organs. It's going to go to your heart. It's going to go to your lungs. Like it's wandering throughout the body. It doesn't literally wander, like it's not moving around, but it connects to parts throughout the body. The vagus nerve is a mixed nerve. It's also the longest nerve in the body. It's longer than any of the other spinal nerves that you have. Longest nerve in the body, pretty cool. So what does it do? It's going to be your main parasympathetic nerve. The parasympathetic is part of the autonomic nervous system, which is controlling things like heart rate and breathing rate and different things that we don't consciously control all the time. It's going to control like your digestive process, things like that. And parasympathetic is opposite of sympathetic. Sympathetic is your stress response. Parasympathetic is your rest and digest response. So whenever you're relaxed, this vagus nerve will be active, telling the different organs what to do whenever your body is in a relaxed state. It would slow your heart rate, slow your breathing rate, increase your digestion, things like that that your body does whenever you're not so stressed. In addition to that, it's also going to provide some sensory and motor input to your throat and your voice box or your larynx. If you remember one thing about the vagus nerve though, remember that it is your main parasympathetic nerve for most of your body. And it also does sensory and motor control of the voice box and the throat. All right, we have two more cranial nerves. O-O-O, to touch and feel very good velvet, ah. And the ah there is A and H, the A for accessory nerve, the H for hypoglossal nerve. So let's take a look at the accessory nerve next. The accessory nerve is going to help control two specific muscles. One is the sternocleidomastoid, the other is the trapezius muscle. So your sternocleidomastoid goes from the back of the skull right here, it's going to connect to the sternum and the clavicle right here. It's gonna help with movements like moving your head down, kind of like this. So that's controlled by that accessory cranial nerve. It also controls the trapezius muscle, which is this large muscle right back in here. That's gonna do a lot of kind of like shoulder movements and stuff. So when you elevate your shoulders, your accessory nerve is helping out with that. Also, when I was reading about this, there's some controversy about whether the accessory nerve is truly a cranial nerve or really actually a spinal nerve. If you look at the diagram, it actually connects down to parts of the spinal cord right here. And they're kind of saying like these beginnings right there are actually part of the vagus nerve potentially. So any textbook that I've looked this up in, it includes the accessory nerve as one of the cranial nerves. So it's probably the best way to remember it as far as that goes. But just know that some people would really classify this as a more of a spinal nerve than a true cranial nerve. Finally, we have our 12th cranial nerve, which is going to be the hypoglossal nerve. The hypoglossal nerve is a motor nerve, and it's going to control most of the movements of the tongue. Your tongue is a muscle. There's also muscles connected to the tongue. So all of those different movements of the tongue, that's going to be your hypoglossal. Hypo means under, Glosso means tongue. So this nerve means it's the nerve under the tongue. Because think about it, the tongue is attached to the bottom of your mouth. And so that's where a lot of those muscles are that are moving that tongue around. Real quick, let's review those 12 cranial nerves using the model from anatomy.app so we can kind of see those three-dimensionally a bit better. First, we've got the olfactory nerve right here, which is, of course, getting information from your nose and sending it to the different parts of the brain here. We've got the optic nerves, and those are actually going to cross each other. It kind of makes an X. So your right eye is going to be sending information back to the left occipital lobe, and your left eye to the right occipital lobe, and that's where that signal crosses right in there. Cranial nerve number 3 is the oculomotor nerve. That's going to be this one right here in blue. And then we've got the trochlear nerve, which is this really thin one in green right there. And then, of course, we've got the abducens nerve right here, which is cranial nerve number 6. Those three nerves, oculomotor, trochlear, and abducens nerve, those are all controlling eye movements. But you can see where they originate is all different. The oculomotor is kind of coming from right in here in the diencephalon. The trochlear nerve is actually going to kind of wrap around to the back right in there and connect. And then the abducens nerve, it's connecting down here kind of to the top of the medulla, right between the medulla and the pons. We've got the trigeminal nerve, which is going to be this really large nerve right here. It's going to, after this part where it's cut off right there, it'll branch off into the three branches. That's cranial nerve number 5, abducens was 6. Number 7 is the facial nerve, also coming off the pons. And then we have the vestibulocochlear nerve. That's going to go to the ear, to the vestibule and the cochlea of the inner ear. Then we have the glossopharyngeal nerve. We've got the vagus nerve right here. And we have the accessory nerve, which is going to have these branches as well as these that kind of come from the spinal cord down here. And then a bit more anterior to those is going to be that hypoglossal nerve, which controls the tongue movements. So those are all the nerves, and you can see those kind of three-dimensionally in the anatomy.app model. So those are the 12 cranial nerves. Now, just by watching up till now in the video doesn't mean that you have these committed to memory and memorized. You've got to practice them. In just a moment, I'm gonna give you a couple blank diagrams that you can use to practice these. And if you need to learn this like for a gross anatomy class in med school, or you just really need to know like what each of these connects to, like what part in the brain it connects to, and the really kind of deeper anatomy of it, then check out anatomy.app, link in the description for that, as well as a coupon code you can use to get 10% off. If you don't need that level of depth, but you're learning all of the nervous system, check out my 2-part nervous system study guide. There's links in the description for that as well. That's gonna break down all this information, organize for you, and help you learn it really well for your test or for your class. All right, here's a blank diagram. Take a moment, pause the video, see if you can go through and identify each of the cranial nerves that we learned, as well as whether they're a sensory, motor, or mixed nerve, as well as what they actually do. All right, here are the names of those nerves, so you can check and see how you did. Now, if you did that, you're partway there. Here's something a little bit tougher. I'm gonna take away the lines as well as the color coding. Pause the video now, see if you can identify all 12 cranial nerves as well as what they do. All right, and here's the answers back so you can check and see how you did. Thank you all for watching, and special thanks to my patrons on Patreon who help support the channel, help me continue making these videos and helping you learn anatomy and physiology. Like I said, I've got a lot of links to different things down in the description, so check out those if you want more help in learning anatomy and physiology, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.